I'd say Canada. But when they ask me what home is, I need to think for a while. See, when I was 4 years old, that's before I moved to Japan, I would have said my home is Canada. Duh. Why are you asking me such a stupid question? But now, I don't know the answer to where my home is, and I look stupid.
After 5 long short years of living in Indonesia, whenever people would force me to say where my home country was, I would hesitate, but I would still say I was from Korea. And I have to say, 5 years was nothing compared to having a series of different schools push into my face. But my friends were like everything, literally everything to me.
In a different language, too. But in Berlin, everyone looked like me. Even though I was still the exact same person, I just suddenly wasn't special That's the Asian table. And the Indian table. And the white table. And there's the mixed table. Maybe I should go sit.
Hey, what's going on? We're doing a survey with new students in school. Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
No, sure.
Do you mind if I butter your muffin?
My what?
I butter your muffin, you know? Never mind. What'd you consider home?
My what?
Your home.
Is he bothering you, Jason? Why are you being such a skeez?
Just being friendly.
Wait, come sit with us. Sit down. So how come I don't know you?
Oh, I'm new. I used to live in India.
Wait, what?
Oh, I also lived in India. I went to an international school.
Wait, what?
Oh, my dad worked there.
I know what international is. I'm not retarded.
Of course.
So you've never actually lived here before?
No.
Shut up! Shut up!
I didn't say anything.
Wow, international. That's really interesting.
That's like so fetch.
Gretchen, what's fetch?
Fetch is slang.
Wait, so if you're from Africa, why are you white?
Oh, gee, Karen, kind of people, where they white?
I guess I'll see you guys later.
You guys all watched the show last night.
Oh, it was so
good. We didn't
good.
Watch it.
Yeah,
it was
the best
episode I've ever seen.
Yeah, yeah, it was like the
That's
best episode of the season so far.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it was
great.
Nobody
yeah.
Oh my god, it was
amazing.
Crazy. That was the best.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, Mike. Yeah, how are you doing?
I'm good.
You know what's even better than that? The show last night.
Funny. People? My friends, they think that I'm shy. They assume that I'm a boring person who doesn't like to talk much, hang out. I mean, I guess, when I do talk, or even try to make a joke, even to save my life. I'm usually the one who makes people feel awkward, who makes them want to leave. Back home, I mean, wherever home actually is, my friends think that I'm French. They call me a French kid who likes to be alone. I'm not like that. I mean, I lived in France for 2 years. Do I look like I'm French? I used to be lively. I used to like to have fun. I mean, I still do like to have fun. I just need time. I need time to recover and settle in. I mean, I move around so much. Can't I just have a little time? A little time to recover from my immigration hangover? But no one cares. No one's willing to wait. No one wants to wait. Everyone just moves along. You know, sometimes I just wish I wasn't a third culture kid. Sometimes I wish I was a first culture kid, that I had a home, and a family that didn't move around. But most importantly, that I had friends who actually liked me.
One of those transformations. There's a part of you. Anyways, whenever I start to feel like that, and I start complaining to my mother, blaming my father and his job, and having me go through all of this, my mother would say to me over and over again how I'm being too full of myself because being able to move around and experience and see things that not many other people can experience and see is a privilege. And I totally get that. I know I'm privileged because I get to experience different cultures, meet different people, get different perspectives on all things. And it's great. I totally appreciate it. But that's not all.
Flight 291 is now boarded. All passengers, please proceed to gate 4.
All right, so this is your ticket now, and your gate is straight into the right.
Finally, after many years of living on the outside, I find myself back in Korea, my passport country, my home. But it feels so distant. There isn't any country I can safely call home without the feeling of uncertainty. Wherever I was always viewed as a foreigner. In Korea, they viewed me as an Indian, and in India, they viewed me as a Korean. So, during moments of attachment, I would find myself being repelled and reminded again and again. Never once have I felt truly accepted by one culture. I was always just me, a mixture of cultures, I guess. I know this sounds very cliche. My mom always says to me that it's only me making myself depressed when there's nothing to be so serious about. But what she and many other people don't understand is that with an airplane ride, with the very airplane ride that other people see as something so big, so wonderful and important, is the very ways I lost the things I loved.
You know, having a multicultural background, it's great. But struggling to keep traditions and my culture in place has left gaps and holes in my identity. I don't even know where I stand in society. And society is so categorized that if you don't have one specific spot, you're out of it. You don't fit in. I'm a global nomad. I'm living in the margin. But there are days where I look outside my window and think, well, actually, being that minority, being the people that don't fit in, it's so bad after all. I mean, I've got the whole world where I can just pick stuff out and create the person that I want to be. That's one heck of an inspiring pool, if you ask me. There's a saying that goes, for everything you've missed, you gain something. For all those things that you gain, you lose something else. And that's exactly who I am. I have stuff from all over the world. But there's stuff from back home that I don't have anymore.
Thank you.